IPU ESAL production upgrade. Liquid bath and metal tapped, anodes removed. Immediately after the cell is stopped, liquid metal and bath has to be removed to avoid freezing of material as the cell is no longer energized. The anodes are also removed to be able to clean the pot's cavity. Cooling and cleaning of pot. After the pot has been stopped, it has to be cooled down and cleaned. A cooling unit is mounted on each side of the pot in the pot line. The remainder of hot electrolyte and alumina must be removed using an excavator. The pot frames and floor elements are removed and the pot's cavity, its superstructure, buzz bar and the pot surroundings are vacuum cleaned. Cathode flexes cut from connector bars. Before the pot can be removed, the cathode flexes have to be cut away from the connector bars. There are 20 pieces of flex bundles on each side of the pot, in total 40 pieces. The flex bundles are removed from the connector bars and accompany the pot shell. Pot shell removed. A pot carrier is placed below the pot. The pot shell is lifted, its foundations removed, and the pot lowered down to the basement onto the carrier. The pot is then transported to the pot relining workshop. Buzz bar and anode flexes cut and transported to contractor's workshop. The two main buzz bar components on each side of the pot are removed. On one side, the bars are cut in two locations and the assemblies lowered down to the basement onto the carrier. They are then transported to the contractor's workshop. Pot hoods removed for modification. Before the pot hoods can be removed, a work platform must be installed. There are four hood tilting brackets. All brackets must be modified. These modifications include machining of components and repositioning of bearings to avoid a clash with the new anode locations. prefabrication of buzz bar at contractor's workshop. There are two main buzz bar assemblies manufactured in the contractor's workshop. To ensure the correct shape and to uphold correct tolerances, the assemblies are constructed in fixtures and welded together using welding plates. Installation of the two main buzz bar assemblies. After the two main buzz bar assemblies have been constructed, they are transported back to the site for installation. The assemblies are transported through the basement on a forklift and lifted in place using a construction crane. Anode beam lowered to the basement and reinforcement of the riser. To have access for the reinforcement of the riser, the anode beam is lowered down to the basement. The riser is cleaned and buzz bar attachments welded onto it. The reinforcement bars are installed and welded on using welding plates. Then the anode beam is lifted into its previous position, the lower part welded and the anode flexes cut from the riser. Welding of the modified buzz bar to the existing buzz bar. After having been installed, the modified buzz bar is welded onto the existing buzz bar. Welding of anode flexes. The anode beam is connected to the main buzz bar assemblies with anodic flexibles. There are 6 bundles of flexes on each pot. Anode beam lifting mechanism. The lifting mechanism of the anode beam is changed to a double motor system and bigger lifting jacks are installed. Milling and drilling of anode beam. The anodes are relocated in the pot. Therefore, the anode beam has to be modified to compensate for this new location. New holes for the anode clamps are drilled using a four drill machine. That is, all four holes for each clamp are drilled simultaneously. New contact surfaces on the anode beam have to be machined, ensuring good electrical contact. Pot shell cradle modification and installation of T-bar. A part of the potline upgrade is installing a new magnetic compensation loop. The magnetic compensation loop consists of a T-bar inserted into the pot shell cradles. This is performed out of the pot rooms. When the pot shell arrives to the pot relining workshop, holes are cut in the pot shell bearing beams or cradles and the side beams to be able to insert the T-bar. After the stiffeners have been welded, the holes are enlarged to make room for the T-bar. The magnetic compensation loop is made out of four bars that are welded together and make up what is called the T-bar. Pot shell reinstalled. The pot shell is transported from the relining workshop to the pot rooms, using the same pot carrier as before. The pot is then installed and aligned, and the carrier removed from the pot room. The duration of the reinstallation is 4 hours. Cathodic flexes and T-bar welded. Cathodic flexes are welded to the connector bars and the magnetic T-bar compensation loop connected. The low guard is then installed and welded in turn. Anode column strengthening. Because of new, bigger and heavier anodes, the foundation of the superstructure, the anode column, has to be strengthened. The same applies to the anode crossbeam that holds up the superstructure's main body.